We've been getting a lot of questions about what is the mortality rate for COVID. And you're seeing a lot of numbers that say it's somewhere around 0.7%. So, unfortunately, there's going to be some math involved because it's a little more complicated than it seems. When you talk about deaths from something, so disease, car accidents, you know, pianos falling at you from the sky, whatever, there's multiple things, ways you can calculate it. One is the mortality rate. And mortality rates are deaths over total population, and then we multiply that by 100,000 so we can compare groups. And what we use mortality rates for more than anything else is either comparing diseases, which is more serious in the population, or comparing disease across populations. That's the first one. The second one is what's called the case fatality rate. And the case fatality rate is the number of people who die from the disease over the number of people who are diagnosed with the disease. And this is usually what people want when they're asking about mortality rates. The third one is the infection fatality rate. And that is the number of people who die divided by the total number of people who are infected with the virus. Now, that is much more difficult to estimate than case fatality rates because we don't necessarily know how many people have been infected. We only know how many people have been diagnosed. We use case fatality rates to approximate infection fatality rates. To show you how they're different, we're going to do a little bit of math. Let's start with mortality rates. As of yesterday, which was the 27th of July, 9 residents of Yuba and Sutter County had died of coronavirus. To calculate the mortality rate, we take 9, divide it by 177,000, and that's roughly the population of our two counties. I made it a nice round number to make the math easy. You divide that, then you multiply it by 100,000, and you get roughly 5 people die of coronavirus per 100,000 people in the area. Okay, what about Sutter and Yuba County? So on the Sutter County side, it's easy. There were 6 people have died, and there's approximately 100,000 of us. So 6 divided by 100,000 times 100,000, and we've got 6 people per 100,000 people die of coronavirus this year. What about the Yuba County side? So the math's a little more complicated because there's not 100,000 people in Yuba County, there's 77,000 people in Yuba County. So 3 people in Yuba County have died, divided by 77,000 people times 100,000 people, and you get about 3.8 or roughly 4. So you can see that's how deaths from coronavirus differ between Sutter County and Yuba County. Sutter County's got about a third more than Yuba County. How do we compare to the state? And this is really where we use mortality rates. Statewide as of yesterday, and we checked the dashboard, state's dashboard today, there had been 18 people who have died of coronavirus in the state of California. And from the Department of Finance, there's about 39,782,870 people in California. So when we do that math, we get roughly 21.4 people per 100,000 die. Now, why is this important? So you can see Sutter County and Yuba County are doing much better at controlling coronavirus and protecting our residents than the state as a whole. And once we know that we're different from the state, better or worse, we can start to look at why. As you can see, when you look, especially when you look at our dashboard, you can see we've got a lot of young people with coronavirus, and we don't have a lot of outbreaks in our nursing homes or amongst other vulnerable people. And that's a major reason why we're doing better than the state. But that's the key purpose of mortality rates, so you can compare across groups easily. Case fatality rate. Overall, we've had, as of yesterday, we've had 9 deaths out of 1,067 people diagnosed with coronavirus. That's a case fatality rate of about 0.84%. We can do it for Sutter County. We've had 6 people die and 670 diagnosed. So that's 0.89%. In Yuba County, 3 people have died, 397 were diagnosed. It's 0.76%. For the whole state, there's been 8518 people have died, and 466,570 people have been diagnosed as of yesterday. That's a case fatality rate of 1.83%. And so you can see they're two very different numbers. Mortality rates allow us to compare across populations. case fatality rates allow us to predict, okay, if you are diagnosed with coronavirus, how likely are you to die? They're two very different numbers for very different purposes. We want everyone to have a good understanding of what the different terms mean because different people will use them differently. And a lot of times you'll see mortality rates reported that are really case fatality rates, and sometimes the press will use one or both interchangeably. So now you know the difference, and when you look at it, you can go, nope, it's this one, not that one. Useful bit of trivia in the event we ever get to have cocktail parties again.